Hello, everybody. Nottis Fan here to bring you some commentary on one of Junk Gaming Video's series in NCAA football. This is his Auburn Dynasty, his coaching Carousel Dynasty with Coach Trollman. Couldn't get Junk in the booth here today to do commentary alongside me, so no dual com this time, but we'll have it for you probably next time, as there'll be yet another good game coming out. But today I bring you Auburn versus Mississippi State. It's the very first SEC game for Coach Trollman, as they will take on Mississippi State here at home and hope for a victory. So here come the Auburn Tigers to the field. War Eagle, baby. Here we go. It is time to get this going. Auburn won their first contest and is 1-0 entering the game. I believe Mississippi State's 0-2, if I saw that correctly. We'll see how this plays out. Now, Coach Trollman inherited this Auburn Tiger team after a 3-9 season and the firing of their head coach. So he comes in trying to turn things around in SEC play, and we get a sack early on. Dak Prescott goes down. Last week we had a quarterback named Chak, C-H-A-C. Now we have Dak. Will he fare any better against this Auburn Tigers defense? So far, no. But it's 3rd and 13 now, and Prescott looking to throw, and he's going to find his man. Morrow turns up the sideline and gets a first down, just enough to move the chains. He needed 13, and he got it. 3rd and 3 now, handoff to Shumpert, and Shumpert is going to break a tackle and get a couple extra yards. The Bulldogs moving the football down the field. Dak Prescott wants to run. He's got nowhere to go. He's going to be swallowed up for another sack, and it'll be 3rd and long. Can this defense bend but then not break once again? That was the name of the game last week against Idaho. This is definitely a better team than Idaho, but that is a 3-yard reception and well short of a first down. Same result as last week. They're going to force field goal attempts. This one is good, right down the middle of the uprights. 3-0 Mississippi State. They score first. Auburn will field this kickoff, getting the ball for the first time. Stevens, halfway back in his own end zone, is going to come out. He's out to the 10 and to the 20. He's got some blocks. 30, 35, tries to spin, but gets pushed out of bounds after crossing the 35-yard line. Wallace quickly to Coates, and this Sammy Coates is something special. 20-yard reception right here. He had a great game in game number one, and he wants to continue it right here. Wallace is going to find Lewis for the first down, and Ricardo Lewis is able to get into the groove here as we are moving the ball in our very first possession. Wallace gets out of the pocket now, and he may run. He's going to do so. He fumbles the football, but out of bounds, and he gets 7 yards. They maintain possession. 2nd and 3, the fullback in the game. Ford is going to work around that and get 6 yards. Jonathan Ford picks up a first down. We are close to the end of the first quarter. Wallace dropping back and some pressure, but he finds Ricardo Lewis for that first and goal. 11-yard reception. That'll end the first quarter with the drive going in, hopefully for a touchdown. Ford is bouncing off of some players and making his way down to the 2. Good run right there. 3rd and goal now. Got to punch this in. Hand off to Ford behind the fullback, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Auburn. And they take the lead. It'll be 7-3 with that extra point. Jonathan Ford scores the touchdown, and the Auburn faithful are happy. They're now on the board and in the lead. So let's see what the defense can do now, trying to trap the running back there. But look at him break out of that. How did he even do that? Derek Milton refused to go down. I'm calling a little cheating going on here by the computer maybe, but I don't know. That was a little crazy there on All-American. We'll have to deal with it, though. That catch is made at the sideline. Morrow, 14 yards and a tough catch. Keeps a foot in bounds. Here comes Dak Prescott putting his head down and getting a first down. And Mississippi State is putting together a nice drive. 2nd and 3. They're right down on the Auburn goal. Prescott gets away, finds Holloway. He spins and falls into the end zone. These guys will not be tackled for anything. That is frustrating if you're the Auburn defense. Getting bodies on players, but they are not going down. We got to do a better job of tackling. And you see Holloway work back to the football when his quarterback scrambled. It worked out perfectly for them as they're able to get in the end zone and get the lead back. It's 10-7 Bulldogs. Wallace, play action. He's loading up down the sideline, and he's got him wide open, except he does not see the football. Bad awareness right there. That could have been a touchdown. 3rd and 10. Wallace, look out. He gets sacked. This drive went in reverse, and that will force a punt. Mississippi State gets the ball back again. Prescott, again, had bodies on him. Not once, but twice, 3 times, 4 times. This guy will not go down. None of these guys want to go down. Look at this run. My goodness. How does he escape all these tackles? Then there's a forearm there or a stiff arm, something. This guy's crazy running the ball. Here he finds Brown passing. Fred Brown will get the first down, 12 yards. Prescott's 5 for 5 passing for 50 yards. Milton, oh wow, once we finally get a body on him, he crumples down. We need more hits like that, apparently. Third and 12 coming up. Big play here. He'll hand off to Milton, and once again, he's bottled up. The second tackler is the one to bring him down. Fourth and 15 coming up. The Bulldogs looking to extend their lead with another field goal, and it too is good. 13-7, Mississippi State, with just a minute and 8 seconds left before halftime. The Tigers will now field the kickoff. This one a little bit shorter, but still in the end zone. Stevens going to take it out to the 10, 15. He finds sideline, 20, 30, 35, 40, and he's across the 40. Another nice return here. Stevens sets up the offense for a chance at a two-minute drill. Let's call it a one-minute drill because that's all that's left. First and 10, and they fake to Ford. Wallace wants to throw. He's got a man, and that's a catch at the sideline. It's Sammy Coates, 28 yards, and now we're really in business. Wallace is rolling to the right hash. The throw to the end zone. Coates has it, and he's in. They give him the touchdown. What a play right here. They strike, and Sammy Coates is truly something special. Wow, how about Wallace getting him the football, though? This is great. Coates is shoved off the line. Wallace takes a huge hit, but delivers to Coates, who also takes a hit and gets across the goal line. It's now 14-13 Auburn. That leaves some time for Mississippi State, though, and here comes Dak Prescott. First down pass to Fred Brown. They are moving the football, 45 seconds now. Prescott wants to throw again. He'll find Brown again. He'll get about 8 yards, second and two, and 40 seconds remaining. A timeout taken, just one left for Mississippi State. Prescott to the sideline, Brown again. He makes the catch and keeps his foot in bounds. What is going on here? This is just back and forth. And we bring some pressure, but they've got a screen. Milton, he's going to fight hard for a first down. That was an extra special effort. Didn't look like he was going to get there, but he fought and he fought. So with 3 seconds left, they've got a field goal attempt, and it is good. Mississippi State takes back the lead at halftime, 16-14 in the seesaw battle. Wow. Good half of football right there as both teams bringing it on offense. So here we go with the ball first in the second half. Wallace DeLumpkin out of the backfield, and he's going to make a catch for 14 yards. That's a good way to start off the half and your first drive. Hand off to Jonathan Ford following his blocks. Going to get a first down and more. 13 yards for Ford, and he only has 34 in the game, but we're going to play action. Fake to him, get the pass to Uzoma. I think that's how you say that, Uzoma. He gets the 11-yard catch. CJ is able to help in the passing game as well. Smith is going to make the catch across the middle. Jason Smith is able to now make his presence known. We're spreading the ball around a little bit in this first half. Wallace is going to boot again. He stops and throws, and that's Ricardo Lewis with the first down. That's a tough catch in traffic. Threaded right between a couple defenders. Let's watch it again. This is nice vision by Wallace to get it through there. Woohoo, that was tricky, but it works. Third and goal now. Wallace is going to get sacked. Ah, they brought it right up the middle, and they hit him hard. Good time for the Bulldogs to bring a blitz, and it is successful. So now it's our chance to kick a field goal. Long makes it good. Auburn is back in the lead, 17-16. Third quarter's winding down, just a minute and change left. Dak Prescott going to hand off to Milton, who gets a first down on the 5-yard run. Let's see what first down brings. Shumpert checks back in, and he's going to go backwards. 5-yard loss. Yeah, we finally figured out how to bring him down. That's nice. Prescott's going to throw to nobody behind his man right there, and it's not going to work. Third and 15. Big play here. If we can make a stop. That's something we haven't done in a while. And oh, that really should have been picked off. Instead, it's punched to the ground. Yeah, we'll take the punt, I guess. So on second and 12, Wallace is going to throw, and he's going to hit Coates, and Coates is destroyed, but he hangs onto the football. Tough 13-yard catch, and that had to hurt. Second and 3 now, and Coates is wide open that time. He's able to catch that one and actually not absorb the hit immediately, so that's good. But oh wow, Ricardo Lewis just got absolutely flattened and thrown around like a rag doll. But once again, holds onto the ball. I think he got hit by multiple defenders there. Made it look pretty bad. Third and five, Coates, he's good for it. Make that a first down catch. He needed five, he got six. Third and 18, this is a big play right here. Right down the middle, CJ Uzomah makes the catch. He gets 18. Oh, he's just short though. Fourth and inches. Look at this hookup. Almost got him the first down. They've got a decision to make right here. They're going to break the huddle, and they look like they're going to go for it, unless they're trying to draw him offside. Wallace, look at that. He shoots right through there in the quarterback sneak and gets more than enough for a first down. Rack it up. First and goal for the Tigers, and looking to tack on to their one-point lead. Wallace on the slant, and it is Ricardo Lewis with the 7-yard touchdown catch. Tough one in traffic. Once again, these guys doing a marvelous job of hanging onto the football when they're being hit. And hit hard. Prescott ducks out of the way of a rusher and then gets that pass off. How do they complete that? No, he didn't. No. That's out of bounds. Fourth and six now. Big play here. They need to have this. Prescott misfires, and it's a turnover on downs. Looks like Coach Trollman's going to win his first SEC game with the Auburn Tigers as they get the ball back. He is quite happy, congratulating his defensive players. With just seconds remaining, they're going to go play action, and are you kidding me? Dagger! Well, let's just add that on for a little bit of rub it in your face right there. Hey, when you're talking about BCS rankings and all that BS that goes into college football, because, yeah, we don't have the playoff yet, you got to do things like that, man. You got to run up the score if it is possible. Here's a Hail Mary attempt, and that's taken away. Look at that. Jones picks it off. Game is over. And let's watch this one more time. As that clock hits triple zeros, they made the attempt to the end zone, which obviously would not have won the game. They're down a couple scores, but nice pick right there. Kind of looked like a rugby scrum the way he got up in the air there and caught that football, almost like he had help from his teammates. But that is a victory. Auburn downs Mississippi State. And Jonathan Wallace, your player of the game, 3 touchdowns. Nearly 250 yards passing. He has a great day for himself. And Auburn's back, baby. They're 2-0. Already just one win away from last season's total. Obviously a very disappointing 3-9 season, but it looks like things are going to turn around a bit this year. 31-16 is your final. And the Tigers get it done for Coach Trollman. So let's see where we're going from here. Obviously, we're going to recap this game, and we're going to get into recruiting and see what lies ahead in the very next week. There is more tough competition coming up. I guarantee you that. Junk went through and made quite a formidable schedule. As a matter of fact, it's number 7 Notre Dame in South Bend. Ugh, that's going to be tough. We're going to bring our A game there. So we got a bunch of recruits that are ready to visit. See if Coach Trollman and his staff can woo them here. When they do show up, it won't be next week because we are on the road at Notre Dame, and that is indeed a tough road ahead. So getting ready for that, we'll just take a quick look at recruiting. Just kind of look at an overview of the board. You see Brian Campbell, a quarterback, is interested in us. We got an athlete there that we're well ahead on. We've got a pretty good situation here for recruiting already. So this is looking promising. We'll just go ahead and adjust some of these points down so we can allot them to the people that we are on the fence with. But as we page down here, you can see some of the players who are already favoriting Auburn in their choices for next year. So recruiting going all right. We are off on the right foot. And next up will be a massive game against Notre Dame. They're number 7. This is going to be huge clash in South Bend. You got to come back for this one. I'll have Junk in the booth with me. Dualcom coming up next time. We'll see you then, guys. I'm not a fan, and I'm out.